Hospitals this afternoon. We are coming to you live from the Lumbee Kabul facility of Gleneagles Global Hospitals, and I'm joined by Dr. Sanukia, who's an endocrinologist here at Gleneagles Global Hospital. So thank you so much
for
joining us this afternoon. Let's talk about diabetes. Now, this is a widely prevalent problem. A lot of people seem to suffer from it, but not a lot of people clearly understand what exactly is diabetes. So can you please help us understand that?
Yeah, that is very good question. This diabetes, as we know and as we know colloquially, this is one of the most commonly afflicted diseases. Especially we can or with the hypertension, obesity, kind of those things. Diabetes, in a nutshell, we can say that it is a disturbance of glucose metabolism, essentially. Mm-hmm. We simply put it as a one sentence. It is a disturbance of glucose metabolism, but it is not complete sentence. To say it comprehensively, it affects all metabolisms, like our fat metabolism, protein metabolism, kind of those things. And also it affects various organs of our body, in which if it is not controlled in time, it can lead to total diminution of our functions. And also various other ailments, like lot of complications that patients might have if there is uncontrolled diabetes.
Right. Sir, what exactly is the cause of this disturbance? The pattern of diabetes that we see in a lot of people.
As we know, like in many settings, any problem that happens to us, it is a multifactorial. Means there are many reasons for that thing. There might be many reasons, but we have to enlist what are the most important reasons, which can be ranked accordingly. So, for example, in diabetes, we can say the first ranking goes to our social and environmental factors. Like our lifestyle, what food we are taking, how much exercise we are doing on a regular basis, not occasionally, and also our economic conditions. Our economic conditions are conducive for our health. For example, a person who is barely living on his day wages, how can he care about his health? Always his struggle is for existence. Unfortunately, in India, most of times what we see is that those who suffer from diabetes often belong to either middle class or lower social strata, because they are deprived of our modern health services.
Sir, now when you say that there are multiple factors associated with it, so can we also say that there are a lot of ways to prevent this particular condition if you take care of certain issues? Would that be right to say?
This is a very good question. Because we have seen this can be multifactorial, because lot of things coming together and causing this one of the ailments, that is diabetes. There are lot of solutions for these things, and we have to prioritize accordingly. This is known as decision analysis. So we have to see which one is most important again. So we have to rank prioringly and give weightage to respective elements. For example, if we have, just now we have discussed, there is a lot of contribution because of our lifestyle things in addition to genetic factors. So how much weightage has to be given? So from early childhood itself, one has to know what will be the long-term complications of our life if we are not following healthy, adequate lifestyles. By 20 years, unfortunately, if we are working like this in sedentary lifestyles, one may catch up having either diabetes or hypertension or some other lifestyle diseases. So from school age itself, they have to think that in what way I can be more healthy to prevent such complications. Because all these things, not only diabetes, hypertension, even related diseases like cancer, they are all related to lifestyle diseases.
Right.
So in a way, we can say decision-making analysis, that is in preventive aspect, one has to be careful and advocate their lifestyle.
Sure. Friends, this afternoon, as we talked to Dr. Sanukia about diabetes, I understand that a lot of you may have either suffered this particular condition or may have somebody at home who may be suffering from this condition. So if you have any thoughts, any questions to ask, feel free to drop them in the comment section, and Dr. Chanukya will be happy to answer these questions for you. Sir, moving on. Now, you did talk about a lot of lifestyle related issues which are modifiable, but in addition to this, sir, are there factors which are non-modifiable? So, how about those conditions?
So, medically, terminology speaking, it might be confusing. There are two kinds of risk factors, as you just told. One is modifiable risk factors. Second one is non-modifiable, or also known as rigid risk factors.
Right.
So what are the rigid risk factors? The genes we inherited from our parents. That is one of the non-modifiable risk factors, because they can't go anywhere. Second one is our age. So as we age, there are some perturbances, means some slight disturbance in our metabolism, which can be either good or bad for health. But if we are having unhealthy lifestyle, they will be more precocious in onset, means rather than at the age of 40 years, they might develop such complications at the age of 20 to 30 years itself. So in nutshell, what happens is that these modifiable and non-modifiable risk factors, they play a very important role. Another non-modifiable risk factor I want to discuss is sex. In female and male, there is not much difference as far as diabetes is concerned, but other lifestyle diseases like thyroid, they have got a sex predilection. For example, if somebody is having thyroid problem in addition to diabetes mellitus, his diabetes management goes haywire. Sometimes they will get high sugar levels, sometimes they got low sugar levels with the same kind of management. So all these modifiable and non-modifiable risk factors has to be considered as a holistic view rather than segregating into different things.
Sure. So coming to the treatment aspect of it, or management aspect of it, a lot of people, I don't know if it is a myth or if it is reality, but a lot of people say that there is no cure for diabetes. So once you have this particular condition for the rest of your life, you're trying to manage this condition rather than cure this condition. So as a as an endocrinologist, as a practitioner of medicine, how much do you agree with this? And is it really just management and not treatment of diabetes?
We have got health. It is not a static concept. Health means, for example, I am healthy today, that doesn't mean that tomorrow I am going to stay healthy. It is continuous dynamic process. Means every minute, every second, our cells in our body changes. Mm-hmm. They continuously replicate. Some cells may die or some cells may be over-functioning. So right. What happens is that because it's a dynamic process, similarly there's a dynamic process of the health. From positive health. Positive health means the highest level of health, where the person is completely free of diseases. From then he may progress to optimal health. Mm-hmm. He is good outwardly. But what happens inside that there may be some replication of abnormal cells. Right. Or some might be dying of cells like our beta cells. Mm-hmm. So he got some perturbances of the glucose metabolism. But outside it doesn't show any features. So over a period of time, if sickness sets in, initially they don't have any symptoms. For example, initial phase of diabetes mellitus, usually classic symptoms that we know is that weight loss, excessive thirst, kind of things, they don't happen.
Right.
Once this thing has been crossed, then as you told, that curative aspect comes. Mm-hmm. That is known as secondary prevention.
Right.
So there are three kinds. Even when you are talking about the word cure, the cure comes in the form of primordial prevention. Primordial prevention means even before the onset of disease, we have to take the risk factors into account. Accordingly, we have to modify our lifestyle. But as the dynamic process progresses from healthy lifestyle to disease, this curative aspect is essentially therapeutic aspect rather than the curative aspect. Therapeutic means treatment will be continued. So we can say if one definitely wants to be cured, they have to think themselves at the age of even childhood also. That's why I insist upon including our lifestyle in school curriculums,
right,
so that people will come to know what they would like to see themselves after certain age, like say 30 years, 40 years, 50 years.
Excellent. I mean, as you were talking about the young generation, now India is already known as the diabetic capital of the world, with so many people suffering from this particular condition. So what are the reasons that you attribute this particular phenomena, and how do we see this panning out in the future as the next generation comes up?
Diabetes, kind of those things, these are known as non-communicable diseases. Previously, if you have seen our health programs, they are essentially communicable diseases like smallpox, polio, leprosy, malaria, kind of those things. But now concentration has been on these non-communicable diseases like our diabetes, hypertension, obesity, cancers, because they are much growing at a faster pace,
right,
because of our modern lifestyles. So these non-communicable diseases, they occupy primary role. This is known as public health program. So once we want to postpone, just now I have discussed it, the awareness should be there among the public. But the main thing is that how to create awareness.
Right.
Most of our programs are for curative purposes or therapeutic purpose, means giving treatment. Once
right.
patient comes to us, then only we are giving treatment, then we are advocating, please do this, please don't do that. That is known as health education.
Right.
But health education is not coming at the primitive level, or
right.
means primary level itself.
Right. Right.
As I told, at the school level, at college level, these persons need to be educated, because everybody wants to stay healthy, but they don't know really, unfortunately, what steps they have to taken care of so that they will remain healthy for their throughout their life. So that's what I advocate. This is known as public health programs. But unfortunately, in India, one has to really dwell into these things, whether government could take over these programs, but it is a remote future. So from private health sector wise, we should take initiative. That's what I feel.
Sure. So talking about the awareness levels now, a lot of people don't have awareness about the kind of diabetes that they have. I'm sure we all know that there are two types of diabetes, but not a lot of us have awareness on what is type 1 and what is type 2, what you should do for type 1 and what you should do about type 2. So can you please explain the difference between type 1 and type 2 diabetes?
So in a thing we can say this diabetes, because this comes because of lack of awareness of our healthy lifestyle. So earlier I have discussed diabetes is nothing but disturbance in the glucose metabolism, to say concisely, briefly,
right,
to be aware to every person in our population. So the diabetes can be as of two types. One is main inertial, because there are so many kinds of diabetes scientific literature, but I don't want to confuse by saying all those things.
Right.
One is because of insulin resistance, that is most common, which we often see in adults, that is known as type 2 diabetes mellitus.
Right.
It accounts for around 90 to 95% of diabetes cases, what we see. But what we see are only tip of an iceberg, because they are, as you told, lot of population is suffering, they don't know diabetes till they suffer.
Right.
For example, if you see 10% of cases, 10 cases in our hospital today, there might be 90 cases,
right,
which might have been in our community, which have left been undiagnosed,
right,
either because of their lack of awareness, or because they may not access the healthcare services, or they themselves don't know health education.
Right.
So coming to other type of diabetes mellitus, that is type 1 diabetes mellitus, this is due to, most often due to insulin deficiency. This insulin deficiency happens because of the one process known as, slight technical term or scientific term I would like to use, that is known as autoimmunity, that destroys the cells. It often happens, but not it is exclusive to childhood, because nowadays, because of our healthy lifestyles and growing obesity, all these things, we are seeing type 2 diabetes mellitus even in children itself, especially in this school age where stress is more on education rather than our physical health.
Right.
So no one is exempt from type 2 or type 1, but 90% of cases are because of insulin resistance, that is known as type 2 diabetes mellitus.
Right. So you have stressed a lot on physical exercise, on activities and active lifestyle and not a sedentary lifestyle. So how much of an impact does, because today's generation is all about sedentary, we have very little physical activity. So how much of an increased risk we are for diabetes with this kind of a lifestyle?
It's a very good question. Rather than saying in a generalized words or a sermon kind of approach, I would like to give an anecdotal example what happened yesterday. I was seeing my patients. After seeing my patients, I finished open and I was coming out. Usually it is my habit to walk to nearest public transport, because though I have got transport, means a car or whatever it is there, wherever possible, I would like to take few steps. This is most important thing. That means we have to cultivate a habit of walking, at least, not even going on steps kind of things in our day-to-day pattern. Many people say that they don't have time for themselves.
Right.
This is quite unfortunate thing.
Yeah.
But at least, rather than criticizing them or trying to judge them, we should incorporate such healthy habits in their day-to-day curriculum.
Right.
For example, if they are going nearby things, rather than taking a car or something other public transport, they can walk to that place if it is safe to do so.
Right.
So, for example, if there is our home or the workplace is nearby 100 meters or 200 meters, we can walk there. And if you use public transport, there are other things. We have to walk to that transport rather than taking out car kind of things.
Right.
These small, small steps will give dividends in long term.
Right.
That's what I feel.
Sure. So friends, we've just had a very detailed and informative discussion on diabetes, the various types of diabetes, the causes, risk factors, and how to prevent diabetes. If you'd like to have more information, you can come to our website or visit us at the Lakhvi Kapoor facility, where Dr. Chanakya is available for a consultation. We wish nothing but the very best of health for you. And sir, before we close, any closing thoughts that you would like to give those who are not currently diabetic rather than those who already are?
Thank you for this thing, for today's presentation. The only thing I would like to say is that stay healthy, be healthy, and be safe. So how to stay healthy is at least do walking for 30 minutes a day, immaterial of the timing, morning or evening. That will give a lot of benefits in long term. I don't like to stress upon this, but it's very important.
Right.
At least walking. I am not advocating to go for treadmill kind of those things. There are other intense form of exercises. So take steps. Few steps are better than nothing.
Right.
Thank you.
Sure. Friends, I think that's a very, very important point. point that at least something is a lot better than not doing anything at all. A lot of times we don't tend to do anything, citing lack of time, lack of opportunity, lack of resources and so on. But I'm sure if we make a little effort, we can take those very few steps, which may just be the difference between good health and being unwell or having any kind of a health condition, primarily diabetes, obesity or hypertension, which then further leads to other kinds of health complications. So thank you so much for joining us. Thank you to the audience for listening to us this afternoon. We hope to see you very soon on another broadcast of Facebook Live with Gleneagles Global Hospitals. Until then, from Dr. Chanakya, myself and everyone here at Gleneagles Global Hospitals, it's thank you and goodbye.